Well, we've had a slew of earnings today, right from Punjab National Bank, GAIL, ACC to Tech Mahindra now, but there are still some left for the day. So let's go across to Sonal Bhutra, who'll tell us what to expect from HPCL this time. Sonal, over to you.
Thanks a lot for that, Anisha. And we are not expecting good set of numbers from HPCL. Remember, IOCL's numbers were also very weak because of higher inventory losses, and that is something that we're expecting from HPCL as well. Well, the Singapore gross refining margins, they are at a multi-year low. They were down 30% sequentially. The gasoline cracks, they have been at a multi-year low. All this will reflect in HPCL's earnings as well. So on the revenue front, we're expecting a decline of 2-odd%. EBITDA is also expected to decline by 53%. Operating profit margins are expected to take a hit of around 210 basis points. And in terms of profitability, there are actually very wide ranges. Some of the brokerages are expecting the company to report a loss, and some of them are expecting a profit. So let's see what the company actually reports. Well, on the refining front, gross refining margin is an important number that we'll be watching out for. HPCL has the lowest GRM across OMCs due to lowest middle distillate yields and also higher share of gasoline. Gasoline is one product where the cracks have been at a multi-year low. Well, due to higher inventory losses, we are expecting very low or even negative GRMs. And the negative GRMs would amount to around -$1.5 per barrel in terms of GRMs for HPCL. Motilal is expecting core GRMs of $3.6 per barrel this time around. And on the marketing front, the gross marketing margins, they are expected at 4.1 rupees per litre. That compares with 3.9 rupees per litre sequentially. So we'll expect some growth out there. And in terms of sales volumes also, we are expecting a growth at 9.8 MMTs versus 9.1 MMTs sequentially. So while on the marketing front, we're expecting some growth, refining is definitely expected to be weaker because of higher inventory losses. Let's see what the numbers really look like. Back to you.
Okay, Sonal, thank you so much for that. But it's time to move on to another story, and this is something tea lovers like you and me would not really appreciate, and that is because the tea bags could get more expensive come July. Now, that is if the tea manufacturers comply with the food regulator's order, which bans manufacture, distribution and sale of tea bags with staple pins. Now, sources tell CNBC TV18 that tea associations are planning to approach the FSSAI to seek extension and discuss the feasibility of this regulation, as it would raise the cost for companies as well as consumers. Priya Sheth has these exclusive details for us. Priya, over to you.
Well, sources say that the Tea Packagers Association of India, as well as the Federation of All India Tea Traders Association, are unhappy with FSSAI's regulation as far as tea bags are concerned. Do remember that India's food regulator, the FSSAI, recently issued a regulation which banned the sale, manufacture as well as distribution of staple tea bags June 30th onwards. Now, essentially what the industry is seeking is a joint consultation of the FSSAI with several of the stakeholders on this issue. They're also seeking an extension of this changeover process, that's the 30th of June that the FSSAI has prescribed as a part of their order. What the industry says is that the changeover process to staple-free tea bags would need import of a lot of new machinery, which would increase manufacturing costs significantly. So 30 to 40% is the increase in costs that the industry is estimating. In fact, we did reach out to all the stakeholders concerned. The Tea Packagers Association of India said that they want the FSSAI to engage with all stakeholders on this issue, and they're replacing machines would increase costs drastically. HUL said that they are aware of this regulation and have, as an industry, plans to move tea bags to non-staple format in a phased manner. Tata Global Beverages said that the process of changeover is well underway and 40% of the tea bags are already staple-free. They're also in the process of working out cost implications as far as this changeover is concerned. Madhu Jayanti International said that they've partially geared up for staple-free production, and the new regulation would increase machine as well as overhead costs 5 to 7 times.
Thank you, Priya, for that.